Hey there, Julian here, back with another update for our GTM Copy Paste extension. Now I'm blown away by the feedback that I've gotten from you guys from this extension that makes it easy to copy paste any kind of tags, triggers and variables over to another account. And it's been really great. I've been publishing this for a week now and I've already gotten loads of feedback, loads of praise as well. So I'm really happy about this and people are actually using it. It makes a difference. So what do I want more? Now, I've already gotten some downloads. We have over 500 downloads now. We have some reviews here as well. So shout out to Thomas, Visani, Rohit, Vladimir, Dilma, and Chris, who have given already a review. Thanks for that. And if you have any reviews or a support message, then please let me know. Now, I've gotten a lot of feedback as well to what I could do better in this extension, and I'd love for you to keep that coming, right? So what I have gathered from the feedback most of the time is that it's pretty clunky that I have to sign up to Chrome. Now, why do I actually have to sign up to Chrome to use this application? For one, I'm using the Chrome Identity API to actually get access or do the OAuth flow to your Google Tag Manager account, so we can actually pull the data and then upload it to your account as well. And this all happens through Chrome, which means that if you have your Chrome connected to a Google account, I can get easier access to Google Tag Manager by asking for the OAuth flow that is built right into Chrome. Really, really handy. But the downside is if you're not logged into Chrome, so that's really what you see up here, it's syncing to my demo account right here. If I'm not logged into Chrome, then I can't really be using the extension. And therefore, it makes it quite hard for people who are not familiar with this whole Chrome syncing thing and why you would even do this, why they can't use the Chrome extension. And it's really just because of the identification or the authentication flow that the application needs to go through. Now, this also poses another problem, because if you have a Google Tag Manager account and you are in one Google Tag Manager account, you copy from here and then you go over to another Google Tag Manager account, then you wouldn't be able to actually upload this because the wrong account is authenticated. You would not be authenticated with this account that you actually logged into Chrome to, and therefore it makes it really hard to copy from one to another account. And therefore, I was sitting down and thinking, how can I solve this problem? And I came up with a solution that actually doesn't involve this Chrome Identity API, although it's very convenient for me as the creator of this extension. I actually opted for a workaround that I come up with, and this involves Firebase. Now, Firebase is this suite of different developer tools that you can pull into for app developers, but also for web developers. And now I'm using the authentication of Firebase actually to authenticate yourself with a Google authentication and then actually give access to your Chrome, your Google Tag Manager authentication. So you don't have to log into Chrome anymore. So let's try this out. If I click on the application, there is a little pop-up here. It takes a little while, I noticed, but then you can choose your account, you can put in your password, and you can say which account it should actually have access to. And it will ask you for all the details that I want to create and gather data from your container. Now, this will not pop up for me because I'm already authenticated with this account. But once this is done, we are ready to go into our application and then again copy and paste as we see fit within that account. Now, what happens if we have something in here and we want to actually copy this over to another account that we also have access to? So, for example, this account here. If I go over and I want to put this into this test account and I paste this, I get an error. Why? Because I'm not authorized to actually upload into this account. That's obvious because I have actually authenticated with another account. So what I have implemented now with this new flow, this makes it also possible to actually log out. So if you click on the menu here and you actually log out, you will be logged out of the application. Next time you click it, again, this pop-up will come up and you can authenticate with the next account that you have available that you actually want to upload to. So in this case, I will go with this account and now it will ask me for my overthrow because I haven't yet done this, and I will allow. And you notice we didn't actually log out and then clear the clipboard. Everything will be staying in the clipboard as you had it before. And then you can just paste it into this existing account that you now are authorized to. And obviously you can copy and paste anything within that account. If you want to do this again with the next account, you would need to log out first and then log in to the next account. So I hope this helps you with some of the problems that some users had by trying to copy between accounts. Now this is possible, you just need to log in and log out, unfortunately, to do all this. But I hope this helps you to make this work when you trying to copy and paste from one account to the next. All right, one other thing that you have already seen, you are now able to log in and the reset clipboard is up here now. So if you wanna empty this, you can do so as well. Now, a new feature that I've also built in is container upload. So you might be aware that a lot of people put out their containers on their blogs or on GitHub and you find these JSON files. These JSON files are normally generated by just going to the admin section and exporting one or the other account. We can just do this for now. You get this JSON file and you can export it and save it to your computer. And then you would need to go into the next account again and import this. Now, a lot of people actually, or people who publish their work, they put this out on GitHub or on their own blog, like Lunametrics. They have a SEO pack here. And I thought, wouldn't it be nice if we could just skip this whole import flow of Google Tag Manager? So I would need to download this, then I need to go over to Google Tag Manager, import this again into the container by just uploading it into the GTM Copy Paste extension. Yes, you can do that now. If you have the JSON file open, and it needs to be valid JSON, otherwise it won't work, obviously. You can now mark this all. You can do this with Control A or Command A on Mac. Huh, this didn't work. Okay, now it's all marked and we can right click and again then say add to GTM copy paste. And voila, we have now our whole container in this extension. And we can go over to our account and then obviously paste this again into the account that we want to implement this in. I need to go to the workspace actually and paste this in. So then all the tags, triggers, and variables that were in this container download will be uploaded to our account. If you wanted to do this with a file that you have already on your computer, or if you wanted to just open this JSON file in the browser, you can do so as well. So just what we did just then, I will just reset the clipboard here. Let's press Command O, or you can also go to your browser settings, file, and just open a file. And then you choose the actual JSON file, and it will open it up in your browser, and you can do exactly the same. Mark this all, right click, and it doesn't work. That is unfortunate. I need to look into this. Anyways, if you find this useful, then I'd love for you to try it out. I will try to get some more bugs out and I love to hear your feedback. Now, this is super important. If you have anything that doesn't work for you or you have a different workflow and you want to make this work, I'd love to hear from you to see if I can actually build this into the application and if it makes sense to put this into the application and make this work. This is actually made for you, so I'd love to hear your feedback. And if you're already using this, then why not give us a review or some support in terms of some feedback? Just write me under this video. I read all the comments and answer them. As always, my name is Julian. Till next time.